Wisconsin sons and daughters stay alive in memory. 18 lives given for our country. Sergeant Kirk Straseski of Beaver Dam was the first Wisconsin life lost in the War on Terror.
I originally thought he was on the helicopter, but then when I heard more of the detail that he was the person that dove in and was trying to help out the pilot and help out, you know, the crew, the first thing that popped into my head is that, you know, it doesn't surprise me about Kirk, because that's just how he was.
Straseski drowned in that canal, dying for the code of honor, caring more about the person next to him than himself. Marine Private First Class Ryan Jerebek of Hobart, Wisconsin, was just 18 years old when enemy fire took his life in Iraq. He was the youngest service member to die in this war.
Every single conversation I had with them was, I love you and be safe.
Right.
And now he is safe. Now he is safe.
Inspired by September 11th to join the Army, Specialist Michael McLaughlin died after a vehicle accident. He is the only Milwaukee native to die in Iraq.
145 days till the 1st of March. Oh yeah, I got your letter. Love, Sweet Pea.
The first woman killed in Iraq survived one attack only to succumb to another. Private First Class Rachel Bosveld of Waupun was 19 years old. Three Wisconsin soldiers died the same day when two Black Hawk helicopters collided in the Iraqi sky after being hit by enemy fire. Staff Sergeant Warrant Hansen of Clintonville, Sergeant Eugene Ewell III of Amherst, and Lieutenant Jeremy Wolf of Menominee.
This was a real hard one, you know, for us.
Army Captain John Hans Kurth knew when he was young he wanted to serve. The West Point graduate saw action in Kosovo and Iraq. A roadside bomb ended his life, taking a well-known son from the town of Columbus. An accidental discharge killed Army Specialist Paul Storino of Racine at 21 years old. His father served in Vietnam.
Most ugliest thing I ever done in my entire life. I stand at the casket and look at my son. He was a good boy.
Private First Class Nicole Fry dreamed of being a firefighter or fighting crime in her hometown of Lena, Wisconsin. The fight in Iraq ended her dreams. She was 19 years old. Major Matthew Schramm joined the Army in 1989. He survived the Gulf War and Somalia. His family lives in Brookfield.
I bet you he doesn't regret anything that happened, actually. He would have done it all over again.
Major Schramm's convoy was ambushed around Memorial Day last May in Iraq. Sergeant First Class Dan Gabrielson devoted 22 years of his life to the U.S. Army. Of Frederick, Wisconsin, he was killed in Iraq last July at 40 years old. And Major Christopher Splinter lived up to his name, building schools in Iraq. The Platteville native was killed Christmas Eve, leaving behind his wife and two children.
He had that military look about himself and his persona, even just the way he walked. He walked with authority.
An Army Private First Class Sean Schneider took charge of his own life, joining the Army, getting married, and serving, all after finishing high school. He earned the Bronze Star after his death in Iraq. Marine Major Brett Becken died during a plane crash in California. The Greendale native was on a nighttime training mission, one of many in his long military career. Also in the Marines, Corporal Jesse Theory was killed in Fallujah last month. The Casco, Wisconsin man planned to marry his fiancée next year. To the Navy, where Petty Officer 2nd Class Michael Anderson served. He died when mortar fire came too close to him in Fallujah. The Oshkosh native was 36 years old.
This one is the one you gave me, so I'm assuming you don't want copies of those.
Poring over which CDs to take overseas before their deployment, Rachel, Charity, and Michelle Whitmer of the Wisconsin National Guard did not realize this moment would be one of their last together. 4 months later, their mother grieves over Michelle's coffin. The specialist's unit was ambushed in Baghdad.
When they came and told me what had happened, I said, why, God, did she have to be the only one who died that day? Why was it her? And the chaplain, which she'd come to know very well in the last 2 weeks before her death, said, Charity, I feel like God laid on my heart this to tell you, he said, because she was the only one ready to go. And she was.
They were all ready. 18 Wisconsin soldiers called to duty. They gave their lives for strangers driven by loyalty and love of their country.